If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Hi, I would like to thank the veterans for keeping my family safe. And
I'm here to thank the veterans for giving their lives and fighting for our freedom.
Hi, I'm Vanessa Montemayor. I would like to thank the veterans for all they've done for us.
And I would like to thank them for making it a better and a safer place for all of us. Thanks.
To all the vets out there, I just want to say thank you for your service, and you are very much appreciated.
I'd like to thank the veterans at Arvada High School for defending us and keeping our country safe.
We would like to thank all the veterans
at Arvada High School for
their service to the country.
Hey, I'd like to thank the veterans of the school for dedicating their time to the military and fighting for this great country. It's a huge honor to know them, and it's a huge honor to know that there's people that have that kind of responsibility here.
Gentlemen, I thank you, and I salute you.
Good morning, Arvada. Today is Veterans Day, Friday, November 11th, 2011. Thank you, Monica Mitchell and the Crimson Report, for that tribute to the veterans who work here at AHS.
And thank you to all the veterans out there who work to keep us safe.
I'm Anna.
And I'm tired of my anchors getting the flu.
And we are here with your daily news.
Athletic boosters will be meeting in the AHS library on Monday, November 14th at 7 o'clock p.m.
If you haven't registered yet for the Turkey Trot, be sure to do so in the library. The race is Thursday at lunch. The cost is $2 for students and $5 for adults.
The money raised will go to AHS Funds for Books. What a great cause. Come run for books.
I love reading, so I will definitely be there.
Great. And another great cause, keep putting money in those November jars and keep your teachers furry.
GSA is the Gay Straight Alliance. Here to tell us more about GSA is Brenda with the club sponsor, Ms. Chavez.
Good morning, Arvada. I'm Brenda Ortega with BDN, and I'm here studying with Ms. Chavez about her GSA. Good morning.
Good morning, Brenda.
So, what is GSA?
GSA stands for Gay Straight Alliance, and my goal with GSA is to provide a safe environment for students who need that kind of support.
That's great. And who is welcome?
As the name suggests, it's Gay Straight Alliance, so everybody is welcome to come to our group.
That's awesome. And what kind of activities do you do?
Well, we meet every first and third Thursday, and some of the activities that we have hosted are Day of Silence, and we've also hosted a hat day to raise money for a local charity.
That's awesome. So when's your next meeting?
Our next meeting will be November 17th, and you guys can see the schedule right here. We'll be meeting in the Little Theater.
And are you hosting a movie? What kind of movie? What is it?
Mm-hmm. We're going to host Philadelphia this time, so all are welcome to come. Bring a snack and a friend, and we'll see you in there.
That's awesome. Well, back to you guys.
Thank you, Brenda. GSA meets the first and third Thursdays of every month at lunch in room B110. New members are always welcome, and the current members want everyone to know that it does get better.
We're golden.
What inspired you to make this film?
There is this project called It Gets Better, and it is about where a bunch of lesbian, gay, transgender, bisexual students go in and they express their feelings, even if they are on the verge of giving up. They listen to a bunch of videos about older gentlemen and women who say it gets better. And I have a bunch of my friends who have inspired me because they persevered through all of the mental and physical abuse throughout their whole life. And it just made me feel like something needs to be done.
What are your thoughts on equal rights?
My thoughts on equal rights? I think everyone should have an equal right. I think everyone should be treated equally no matter who you are, no matter what you do. You are who you are and no one should change that. In depth, what do you mean?
Like, what did people say to you? Like, death threats? Like, did you get any death threats? Like, people are gonna hurt you, gonna try and kill you, burn down your house? Anything like that? Like, what did people say to you?
In high school, I have not gotten many death threats or hate crimes, but in middle school, it happened all the time. I have been threatened. I have been threatened. I have been beaten. I have been hazed. It's not okay. I have been threatened saying people are going to do stuff to me that it's not okay with. I don't really want to go into depth with what it was, but it wasn't okay.
You are who you
are. Gets better, you do matter.
Don't underestimate the kindness of others.
It gets better. Trust me, it gets better.
I know how you feel, but you are worth it. Everybody is worth everything. There are songs to be sung, there's art to be made. You are perfect and wonderful, just who you are. Don't ever let anybody get you down. Because everybody should be treated equally, no matter who you are, no matter what your sexual orientation is, you are you, it shouldn't be any different.
Wow, thanks Shy Bumpus for that. And now back to Brenda with Ms. Chavez and Mr. Carter.
I'm here with Mr. Carter and Ms. Chavez about the Latin Dance Club. So what kind of dance is it?
We started off with merengue, that's the easiest, and we went for about 6 weeks, and then we moved on to salsa, which we're going to finish up this week, and then to round up the year, we're going to do bachata.
That's awesome. And is it hard or easy?
I think it's difficult, but with a lot of practice, kids tend to be successful and they really enjoy it.
That's great. So what was your reason to start the club?
We just thought we could bring together a lot of different kids in a fun activity. We have ESL kids that are coming, we have kids who are in the Spanish program coming, and we have
Latino kids that know a little bit about it, and it's a nice mix of students.
That's great. When do you meet?
We meet every Thursday at 2:30, so I hope to see you there.
That's great. So remember, Arvada, if you're not busy, try it out and see if you like it. Back to you.
Ms. Chavez is a really busy lady. GSA, dance club, and teaching? That's a lot.
That's all we have for you today. We'll see you back here on Monday for more of your Bulldog News.
Have a great day, Arvada. Cause cold nostalgia
chills me too. It's a great day to be in Arvada Bulldog. But drenched in vanilla twilight, I'll sit on the front porch all night, waist deep in thought because when I think.
GSA is the Gay Straight Alliance. Uh-oh, I screwed up.
What kind of activities do they do?
That wasn't the next question.
I don't know.